Pastor Bowler is saying you're very nice. Can we have a prayer?
We are praying. Our gracious and lovely Father in heaven, we come before your throne, Lord, round about your throne are the seraphims, Lord, that praise your name day and night. And they cover their face, their feet, because they cannot withstand your glory. And we come before your throne covering our face, says, because we cannot stand your glory. We pray that you forgive our sins. As we are starting our program, Father Lord, we pray that you begin with us. Be with us. We pray that any evil force that would want to come and disturb, we are banished in Jesus' name. May you come and be with us and end with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much, Pastor, for that powerful prayer. Colleagues, we may be seated so that we can begin our program in a minute. We are coming to the end of the year, and we thought it would be fitting that the President of the United Party for National Development, UPND, President Hakainde Hichilema, should address the nation through the media to reflect on what has happened and where we're going. In addressing these issues, President Hakainde Hichilema is going to be assisted by other senior party officials in addressing these issues. This press conference is also being carried live on Diamond TV and Prime TV and several other radio stations throughout the country. So at this juncture, I would like to invite the National Chairman, Honorable Dr. Reverend Mtale Nalumango, to greet you, as well as have the honor and privilege to invite the President to address the press conference.
Let me ask Honorable Msopatwane to say a few words and greet you before I greet you too.
Zambia!
Forward.
Zambia!
Forward.
Zambia!
Forward.
Good morning to all of you. And Happy New Year. If there is. Thank you.
Zambia!
Forward the way!
Zambia!
Forward the way!
Everybody to move forward. I think we have been in reverse for too long. 2016, Mr. President and colleagues, was very, very, very spiritually clear. There were two groupings. One said forward, the other one said backward. Do not reverse. And for some reason, we fell into the trap of do not reverse. Today, we fell into the trap. Whether they stop, they did what? We have been moving backwards. Scripturally, we would say it's a setback spirit that was set, released upon our country. And I think today, nobody can argue with that, because everybody has seen that we have been moving backwards at a speed that is extremely destructive. But today, Zambians must make up their minds, as I pray, Mr. President, that they stand still until we choose together to move forward. We are looking forward. We will surely move forward under the leadership of President Hakainde Hichilema. Twachula, pafula. Let us not allow this spirit of setback. Enough is enough. Na iwa wine PF. Ushewe taule chumfwa. Ushewe PF taule ya yumfu ensala. Ushewe PF taule ya yumfu obuchushi. Oh, limbina yuwa laliyako esha mkula. Belonga tauli yako. Mwenye nane. Aba anabobe bachuli la mo. Let us move Zambia forward. It is not my day. I don't know whether I am supposed to call upon the president right away so that we listen to the voice of wisdom, to direction, to counsel to those that may have ears. For others have accused us, Mr. President, that we never give any alternative. We never advise this government. We do all the time. Even from this point where I'm standing, we have told them now and again what not to do and what to do. But they never listen. But once again, my president will try. Once again, he will try to give direction and counsel and see whether somebody can listen out there. Mr. President, I call upon you.
Thank you very much. I asked the media to allow me to speak while seated because that's the way you have arranged the equipment here. If that's okay, then we should proceed. Good morning, everybody.
Good
morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thank you very much. First, I would like to recognize our colleagues in the media for coming to this press briefing and for your support. Over the months in 2019. It's been very difficult for you, but you've been there. Thank you so much. I want to thank the colleagues out there, the members that are seated with the media, and the general, if you like, cadership. We're all cadres of this party, but we're grateful for the support that you've been rendering to the party, to your families. I want to recognize the colleagues that are seated with me here. Chair, National Chair, thank you very much. I continue on my right, Chairperson, Women, and Secretary General, and the group that continues there. And Honorable Msukutwane, Rebecca Msukutwane, our whip in the House, and Chairman Economics and Finance in our party, thank you for being here. Madam Masebo, Honorable Masebo, Chair, Mobilization, thank you for being here. Our senior citizen, Mr. Mwale, Joe Mwale, Ambassador Mwale, I must say, thank you, sir, for being available for this young population, even when you are supposed to be resting peacefully. But I know your heart, you can't rest peacefully when your children, your grandchildren are hurting, as it is today. Thank you to the provincial chair. I have already touched on the fact that 2019 has been a very, very, very difficult year. Extremely difficult year for all our citizens, except a few. Except Mukula One and his small group. It's been difficult for everybody. But before I proceed on that score, I would like to simply once more thank all our party officials, all our members, all our sympathizers across the country, for surviving the hostile political environment in 2019. You have done a lot. You have expanded the party. We have won by-elections under almost impossible conditions. I have in mind Sesheke in February 2019. I have in mind our support to our colleagues in NDC with regard to the Ron by-elections. Very, very difficult by-elections, but you were there. I have in mind Katuba constituents, where you did a wonderful job against all and sorts, manner of corruption. You did the best that you could. I'm aware of what you were able to do in Kaoma not long ago. And most recently, your performance, our performance in the Lambo Ward of Lukososhi. Congratulations for making progress in a negative environment. Please welcome. Zigo Mubambi for that. Times we forget you temporarily, but you are always in our minds. I want to thank the church for their spiritual guidance, not just to us in the UPND, but to the country as a whole. Again, under a very hostile environment, where in 2019 we saw the pronouncement against the constitutional provisions of freedom of worship, where if you are not Christians for somebody, you could be attacked right in church, having your normal service or having a meeting in the church premises. So thank you to the church, thank you to the civil society for standing up to this brutal regime. Thank you so much. I know you've paid the price, like many of us, but we want to recognize your efforts. Laura Minti, Pilato, Fumba. We know what happened to these two not long ago for standing up to protect citizens. We want to thank our civil servants who have continued to deliver some service to the public, even when they are faced with retirements in national interest or public interest, for simply conducting their noble duty for which they are employed by the people of Zambia. Very, very appreciative of what these citizens are doing. We want to thank our farmers who have continued to do some kind of production, to produce something, even when fertilizer is delivered late, even when seed is delivered late, even when they pay a deposit for their FISIP, e-voucher, whatever you want to call it, and the inputs are never delivered. We are aware that, and we must thank them, the agro dealers, who have been able to deliver inputs, farming inputs, and yet they've never been paid by this PF government. Never. And they're queuing for the service that they rendered to be paid for. And no payment is forthcoming. And most of them who use their houses, their properties as security for their working capital are losing their homes. It's a very difficult situation, but they've continued serving our people. We want to thank our men and women in uniform for keeping us safe in our country, even under these circumstances. I think it would be amiss, I would be amiss if I did not thank the general citizenry, our countrymen and women, who have remained strong, very, very strong under trying moments. I have never seen the resilience that I'm seeing in the people of Zambia. I've been around long enough to know that this is the worst time that citizens are having to raise their children in, that they're having to maintain marriages. It's a very, very difficult time. But they've continued, they've soldiered on. Your resilience will be rewarded very soon. It will be rewarded accordingly. But thank you for this. Not just for your families, but for all of us. Let me have a quick look at 2019. And to be specific, away from generalities, but to specifics. And I'll tackle some of the subjects item by item as much as I can. Our reflections of 2019, starting with governance and human rights. This has once again been one of the most repressive years in the history of our country. We like saying in the independent Zambia, history of the independent Zambia. I want to go back to the colonial days. What we're experiencing today, 2019, under the PF, in terms of governance and human rights, is probably the worst, even when you include the colonial time. Evidence is there. It is there in abundance. Not in small doses, but in abundance. So, we are basically living in a police state. It's not been declared officially, but in practice, we're living in a police state where if you offer any difference or you hold a different opinion from those in office, it could lead you into police cells. Filthy police cells. Obviously, Marity knows that. He knows that. And a couple of people around this place today, they know that. I know that very well. 15 times, in and out, for simply expressing an opinion that is a divergent, or that's divergent from those in office. It shouldn't be like that. Because our freedoms of expression, conscience, assembly, are assured in the Bill of Rights, in our Constitution. But they are not being respected. Some of our people remain in police custody today for crimes they did not commit. Even when they can be given police bond, that is denied. Denied of. And they remain in filthy police cells. Those death traps. Some of them are in police cells or prison cells because a crime that has been ascribed to them, which they did not commit, although it's bailable, they are not able to get bail. Because the bail conditions are created in a way that makes it impossible for our ordinary citizens to meet those bail conditions. This is unacceptable. Prisons are not meant for anyone, anyhow. They are meant for those who are found guilty of one crime or another. But in 2019, we continue to see this abuse of human rights. In my time in Mukobeko, I was shocked. The colleagues that I was sharing cells with. Why was I shocked? And they've continued being in those cells, prison cells. It's because, although the criminal justice system, our criminal justice system, presumes everybody innocent until proven guilty, that's not being applied. We didn't see that being applied under the PF as a continuation of the PF way of running the country. What else? Why are they still there? Our law says that anyone who is arrested on suspicion of any crime ought to be taken to court, must appear before a competent court of law within 48 hours from the time they are arrested. 48 hours. But there in Mukobeko, they are inmates, we shouldn't even call them inmates, they are detainees who I shared cells with, who have been in prison for 15 years. They've never seen the doors of a courtroom. Where is law and order? Where are the human rights, liberties and freedoms? This is the situation that's obtaining out there. And it continued in 2019. I actually thank God. Very ironic that I was taken to Lilai, I was taken to Chimbokaila prison, I was taken to Lilai. I think God was showing me something, that when your time comes in office, you better resolve these issues. Amen. And we're going to resolve. got exposed to the draconian butane, the dreaded butane in 2019, which was devoid of a process that was consultative, a process that was inclusive. So, in reverse, the butane process worked on exclusions, the butane process worked on, if you like, lack of consultation. And that's why all of us, well-meaning Zambians, did well to oppose it. Temporarily, as it may be, butane has been put aside. We are aware of what the PF are doing during the parliamentary recess to try and cajole some colleagues, some MPs, to support butane. Butane will not be acceptable in any form or shape that does not or will have not resulted from a process of inclusiveness and consultations. So cajoling someone will not help. Am I not a proud leader of the UPND to say through the whip here, Dr. Msokotwane, to thank the UPND members of parliament who stood up on the right side of history, on the right side of the people with regard to butane? Why shouldn't I thank you? Thank you very much. Why shouldn't we thank the four independent members of parliament who stood on the right side of history on butane? Thank you to them. Why shouldn't we and I, you and I, thank the NDC member of parliament for Ron? I am proud, we are proud as UPND that we went to campaign for him because he stood on the right side of history. To people outside parliament, civil society, churches, trade unions, who for once stood up to be on the side of the people. They too, we should say thank you. Pressure, encouragement to those of you, Dr. Msokotwane, who are in parliament, comes from outside as well, outside parliament. So we must thank them. In 2019, we saw the continuation of political violence, which extended beyond politics into community violence, violence at bus stops, violence at markets, public places, where citizens could not use those facilities freely because a party called PF has armed a small number of thugs to terrorize people, to deny people access to those markets, to those bus stops. We've talked about it. We talked about it. Chair, in your comment, you said they accuse us of not giving advice. We have been giving advice. And we said, leave the markets. Leave the markets, leave the bus stops. Leave taxi vans so that taxi drivers, our taxi drivers, can operate freely under these harsh conditions, so that our truck drivers can operate freely, don't harass them, so that the councils can collect revenue from markets. Fair revenue, I mean. And since we pushed for that, there's been at least a slide on the aggressiveness from those small numbers of PF. And we've now seen councils collecting some reasonable revenue, which was going to individuals to fund themselves, to lead lavish lives, and to fund PF. We can't have public assets funding a political party and a few individuals. It's what we saw in 2019. I could say more. But I think it's important that I move to the next item. How was 2019 with regard to the economy, to the welfare of the people? How was it? The scorecard on the welfare of the people. How did it turn out to be? I have never seen, as an adult in this country, I have never seen the economy performing so poorly than what we experienced in 2019. I've never. I don't know about you. There is simply nothing that you can point at that this is positive. Starting with hunger, our citizens are hungry. Families, 2019, ended up reaching some consensus, I don't know how they did it, to have one meal a day. Or to share, if there are 10 members in a household, 5 will eat lunch, the other 5 will eat supper. How can anyone say they are leading a country and people are dancing this Dununa reverse devilish song when people have not eaten? And you wake up in the morning, you say, I'm leading something. What are you leading?
Shame.
You are leading in hunger? Are you happy that citizens, children go to school without food? That's what happened in 2019. That's what we experienced. We experienced the 2019 where children who are school going, age, left school, a lot of them. Don't ask me if it's true. I know. Because I support many orphans in school. I know that the people knocking on my small facility have increased in 2019 to access that small private facility where we support vulnerable children in school. The pressure has grown. I know it has grown for all of you who are viewed to be able to support one or two extra people. This is 2019. 2019 saw us run through a situation where a college graduate who completed school 4 years ago, they've continued walking the streets looking for a job, but there's none. I know as I'm speaking now, there is a graduate out there, college, university graduate, who is agreeing with me. Not one, not two, not hundred, but thousands of them. Did we give them hope in 2019? No. I'm aware that you are aware that in 2019, there is absolutely no money in our bank accounts, citizens' bank accounts. There's no money. If you keep money under a mattress, that mattress now is flat. Before it used to bulge because you used to keep money under a mattress. Now it's flat because there's no money to keep under a mattress. There's nothing. It's 2019 for us. A journalist seated here, half of her mind or his mind is that, how will I buy the next bag of minimum? That applies to everybody. We've seen a situation where PF found a bag of minimum at around 30 kwacha. Now it's 170 kwacha. But your incomes have gone down in real terms, even in nominal terms. I don't want to use complicated words. In simple language, the money you receive, ndala mamuru kufola, sizigula vintu vambiri, koma, sizigula vintu vambiri, koma mutengo wa vintu, waenda mumami. Already you are stressed. Muzagula vintu vingono, vingono, vingono. We have seen homes breaking 2019 because of economic conditions. Yes, we have seen Misepela, Tamule Upa, Muletinokupa, Muletinokupa. This is not a joke. Mwana wabantu ukamuleta munganda uzamujesa chiani. Wasala uniwe uli kungurume. Kuma kukwati la ofuna. Manje uzamujesa chiani, uzamuvalika chiani. This is the situation out there. Wives are beginning to think that husbands don't care for them anymore. But husbands are trying very hard. Single mothers are trying very hard. This is very, very difficult for them. I talked about jobs already. Kuna misebenzi. But try business. Did you manage to succeed in business in 2019? If you are selling tomato, unalugulisa 5 boxes per day. Masiku ya 2019, ngati waenda kumariketi, wagulisa boxi mozi ulinamwai. Because wagula kulipe. This scenario affects everybody. You are a widow. Your husband left you 2 houses. You move from the Woodlands house to a Chilenje house. So you can rent the Woodlands house. There's no tenant. That's the economy. Today I'm not using micro, macro. I'm talking about the economy in the way you understand it. Yes. There's nothing. So where do people go to? What do they do? You are already unemployed. You are a dependent. Then all of a sudden, the one who looks after you is retrenched. 2019. Then you look to an uncle who was retrenched some years back, that they will be paid their retrenchment benefits. Their benefits are not paid. People are sleeping outside, singing, worshipping there, outside the ministry of, well, justice ministry. And that minister, last week I saw him at a party where everybody was wearing white. And he was dancing to the floor, showing a lavish lifestyle when retrenchees, retirees are singing, are begging, are pleading at his doorstep. Every day he comes there, packs a VX that belongs to those retrenchees that buy him the fuel. And last week he was dancing all in white party. Yes. For many of us, we saw hardships. But for a click in PF, 2019 was party after party after party. But tomorrow, Luvinda will go to the families of those retrenchees and say, Munipase vote, nifuna kuimira mukawata. Mukamuyangane na manso ya tatu. Mukamuyangane na liso limozi, lina angu mukavale. Mwayanga na one eye. I'm sure some of you know the part I'm talking about, where you saw obscenities there. Basically making love in public. So, my message is that this is what 2019 had for us. No business. I've been doing business myself for 32 years. Mm. I started building as a business as a young fellow. 32 years. I have never seen a situation I saw in 2019 that your clients don't pay. They don't pay, you push them. They say, HH, we have not paid because we have not been paid also. And the chain goes. The economy has collapsed. In technical language, our balance sheet, we are insolvent. Means we are bankrupt. We saw a situation after arguing. I talked about the balance sheet for the first time using a terminology I shouldn't have used. But I will explain it. Our assets are wiped out. Wiped out by what? By one single item coming out of carelessness and imprudence called debt. Kongole, Kalova. $19 billion. The country has never experienced this level of debt since independence. We've never. Even when we gave them advice, don't borrow too much. They went ahead and borrowed. Chairman, you're talking about advice. We advised, don't borrow. They went and borrowed too much. Did they just borrow? No. They borrowed at a high cost. Even after we told them that this would choke the economy. And no one listened to us. Today we are where we are. What did they use the borrowed money for? They used the borrowed money to steal through corruption. Where did they take it? Where was the opportunity to steal? In roads. Expensive roads. A road that's 300 kilometers, third road, should cost no more than $300 million. What do we see? $1.2 billion. So $1.2 billion, it means they've stolen $900 million. No shame. As a businessman, I know this gentleman is a businessman. I know that. Before I started my business, he was already doing business. I used to admire him. He didn't know that. I never told him that. In his quiet ways. Because in this country, we promote noise making. Noise making, we think, means correct. Noise usually arises from emptiness. Right? It has been very, very difficult. We said, do not borrow too much, they borrow too much. Do not borrow at a high cost, they borrowed at a high cost. Where did they take the money? Corruption. Roads. Buying fertilizer at a high cost when we can buy it at a low cost. We gave the formula before how to lower the cost of fertilizer. It's there. We gave them the argument that you can't buy ambulances at $280,000 when you can pay $65,000, $70,000. Where did that money go? Corruption. 2019 for you. The lingering legacy of the fire tenders, that should have cost $300,000, but were paid bought at $1 million each, we lost close to $30 million. Loss after loss after loss, even when they were given advice after advice after advice. Who pays the price? It is you, citizens. Today someone is saying, vote for me in 2021. Sevens are thirsty. Gwiranchito thirsty. Ukarina almost 2 years. What do you want 2021 for? At least we are saying, 2021, this is what we are going to do. And we'll tell you just now. But someone is already there. They are crying for 2021. Kabaka Munganda umo. We are quite a church, Muzabara Mwana. I'm using that as semantics. I don't want someone to say, no, HH was abusive. I'm not abusive. I am saying PF is failing to deliver. The economy has been destroyed. And they are telling you that 2021 is a winner. You've not delivered from 2011. Everything has collapsed. If you go in the hospitals today, there are no medicines. A delivering mother has to buy her own cotton wool to take to a delivery room. She has to buy antiseptic. She has to buy syringes. She has to buy surgical gloves. So where is the state money? Former finance minister, what is the job of the treasury? Where is the money going?
Dubai.
Buying tear gas. Buying bullets. Buying pangas, going to buy elections, buying bicycles branded PF in green, no shame. Buying councillors, turning human beings into tomatoes in a market. What else are they doing? Lavishing, building lavish homes in Forest 27. The only people, I've said to you, we've been in business a long time, the only people now building expensively, now, 2019, Forest 27, diggers hitting the water source, destroying it, yet they're saying they want to manage climate change. What do you mean? You're destroying climate, the climate. You're destroying the water sources by diggers hitting Forest 27. Then you are saying, ah, even andala maimwe, the pirani taxi ambili, teach them manage climate, but you are destroying the water source in Forest 27. That man is going to build mansions there. I went there incognito, and I'm encouraging you to drive in that direction. See the new roads they're doing there. Just see where your money is going. Public money is pushed into private projects, because by building a road there, which is unproductive, and we'll talk about it that very soon on remedies, it means they're shifting money that should go into production, they're taking it to consumption for a few, a small few. Then you are a PF cadre who supported the Red Sata. You are true green. And they come to you, they say, no, pick a gun, go and shoot and kill Lawrence Banda. They are building mansions. They are using you to kill Lawrence Banda, to kill Mapenzi Chibulo, to kill Grace Yamataka, to kill our NDC colleague who was killed in Rwanda. They are lavishing, you are getting nothing. Say no to those assignments going into 2020. Say no to those assignments, because naive ule chula. I can go on and on. I have given you a test of 2019 in terms of the economy. They've killed KCM. We told them, don't put it into liquidation. You can put it under management so that you can continue mining, so that you can protect the assets. What did they do? They appointed a cadre, a PF cadre, to be a liquidator in KCM. What are you seeing in KCM now? They've destroyed the KCM. Then they see the Kwacha losing value. They've forgotten that the action they took in KCM now has led to a situation that KCM is not earning foreign exchange anymore. So you have a short supply of foreign exchange. What do you get? The Kwacha depreciates. You found the Kwacha at 6 Kwacha to a dollar. Now you've taken it to 14 Kwacha. Last week, after destroying the banking sector, the business sector, by increasing the statutory reserve ratios, if you like, siphoning money from the economy, from businesses, putting it away, you immobilize it, the Kwacha appreciates a little bit. Then someone was mocking me and said, where is HH? You must comment now. The question is appreciating. Where now? What appreciation? From 14 kwacha to 13 kwacha. Where did you find the kwacha? 6 kwacha. What's the news as our poor will? That is not Maynard Keynes economics. That is not. Someone cuts his salary by 20%. Let's assume the salary is 100,000 kwacha. You cut it by 20%. And you are saying that it will alleviate the electricity increases, which is what we saw in 2019. Fuel increases, what we saw in 2019. What economics is that? You cut it by 20%, you have, in your mind, you have saved 20,000 kwacha. You have not saved anything, sir, because your night allowance is 5,000 kwacha, $5,000 per night. Your night allowance alone is 60,000 kwacha. If you have saved for a month 20,000 kwacha, 60 less 20, you are still out by 50,000 kwacha. Maybe that's chagwanomics. Even in the days of Adam Smith, even that time when technology has not advanced, Adam Smith could have never thought in that way. The wealth of nations. There is no duping people of Zambia. That announcement was a panic reaction. His recognition for the first time that the economy is gone. Because they've been saying the economy is okay. We tell them, don't sell the maize. They say, no, there's enough maize. That's why you saw an increase in the price of maize. Didn't we tell them, Jay? Right here. Panopen. Bonawa. Right. I cannot continue talking about what you know. I cannot. So I want to say, how did we get there? How did we get to a situation where there's no economy? How did we get to a situation where the economy, which was growing at 7% in 2011, a build-up to 2%, actually, I can bet with you, unless they cook numbers, they cannot achieve 2% growth rate in 2019. Which sector would deliver growth? Not energy? Not agriculture? Not mining? Which one? So it's not possible. How did we get to a situation where PF inherits an economy growing at 7%, they wipe it to less than 2%? How did we get there? How did it happen? Who is responsible? It's a leadership crisis. It's a leadership crisis. It's a rampant corruption. We can give all sorts of excuses. Mr. Climate Change now is responsible for everything. Mr. Climate Change, where does he live? Where does she live? Right? We can complain about Kariba Dam. We can complain about the rainfall. Yes, we know. Loaziba. We know that there's a climate change situation. But because there's no quality leadership, you don't see mitigation measures that will ameliorate, that will reduce the difficulties that Zambians saw in 2019. How is it that because Kariba Dam levels are low, we have load shedding like we've never seen before? Yet in Dubai, where there's not even a small dam, there is electricity 24/7. What is the difference? It's the quality of leadership. Epela. And Ditamwai. It's the quality of leadership. Why would you have a leadership that Fico 2019, most of you have forgotten. I was taken to Ndola to be arrested because I talked about Safiko. Have you forgotten? Why would you want to sell Safiko now? When Zafiko land is sitting on a lot of minerals, you want to sell Zafiko as a company and you ignore the minerals that are lying under there. Hand over the minerals to someone so that they can give you a backhander. Corruption. What we receive when we advise is threats of arrest. That's what we receive. Instead of people listening to us, if they listened to us, we wouldn't be where we are. If there was leadership, we wouldn't be where we are. Now, they denied then in 2019 that no, HHR leve povufi, HHR ite mafia kulanda randa. Ama kwenda ukamba manini. Ni makamba ngati vintu, si vintu, si vili buino. And when I speak, don't send policemen at my house. Listen to what we are saying. We talked about 48 houses. Who is the owner? Who built them? Up to now, no answer. What did they do? They went, someone went to parliament and said, it's Dr. Musokotwane's nephew who owns those houses. Can you imagine how something that's supposed to be a leadership response to issues? Right? And it took Situ here, I think, to explain himself in that house. I'm sure I remember that you raised a matter in the house and it was clarified. But the nation, many citizens, sorry. Right. He's just reminding me. The MP who accused a non-existent, a fictitious Dr. Musokotwane's cousin to be the owner of the 48 houses, he had to apologize on the floor of the house. Bubera, bubufi, bubeja buhata, bubera, bubera buhata, magisha waka kuyuka. Bubera. Now, that's a leadership. I'm talking about leadership. That's a leadership that responds in that manner when there's a serious matter. That time, I returned to Zafiko. They threatened to arrest me and actually detained Zafiko workers and some unions. They said, HH is lying. We never sold, never intended to sell Zafiko. Today, it is official, they are selling Zafiko. The thing I told you some time back, as I told them about the collapsing economy, as I told them about the kwacha, as I told them about corruption, we told them. When I say I represent all of you and other silent Zambians, including Zambians in PF. Listen to the PF voice notes. They are aware that their own government is leaderless, it is corrupt, it is selfish. That would rather pay $42 million to Eskom, pay foreign exchange to Eskom, to a South African company, instead of paying Mamba Collieries, so that we can empower from Mamba Collieries. Where is the leadership? Where is common sense if that's all you need? Because if you send $42 million to Eskom, you are exporting jobs, you are maintaining jobs in South Africa, and losing the jobs in Mamba. Weo, ni chinchi. Ni chinchi. Yeah.
Where did you grow up from? How were you taught? What were you taught? Do you care about the people? Then you complain the kwacha goes to 14. The day the kwacha, 2 days or so, the kwacha went to 14 is after they were raising $20 million to send to ESCO. It pushed the kwacha. It pushed the cost of goods and services up. You punish more people. Then you say, no, we are providing leadership. Which leadership? Which leadership? It's the absence of Malume. It's the absence of leadership. Ziko yaono ngeka kupeta uke vitu sivili buino. Kupeta uke kwa mene kuja kwa sukuja. Sivili buino. Because there's no leadership. You see, the beauty about these things, you may rig an election, but you can't rig an economy. You can't. So, it's a leadership issue. When the leadership is serious about the country, we will bring fertilizer on time and deliver to farmers at a lower cost. When there's leadership, and I'm clear here, UPND leadership, those are the remedies. We will be able to import fuel in a manner that is devoid of corruption, middlemen along the way, and deliver fuel at a pump at a lower cost. And that will lower the cost of doing business. When there's a leadership, we will focus on one fundamental, that is the economy. 2020, we are giving them advice. We are willing to help the people of Zambia, not the PF, to turn around this economy. It is the economy that we must turn around. To turn around the economy, to push it back to 7% growth, that's our remedy. Manage our guys, please. Let's continue with this. All you need is one guy to manage those guys. So, youth chairman, manage the guys. Thank you. Thank you. 20. Time is money. Ndawi muona is doshmak. Ndalama. We know that, but the PF does not understand that. So, I am saying, going into 2020, we must begin to resolve the issue of leadership. It is the leadership that will turn around this economy, because the one single bullet we need to solve the economic crisis we've seen is to turn around the economy. That's a golden bullet. To turn around the economy, you need good leadership. You need a team. Starting at the top there, you need vision. Chimonwa. Ngatawapote chimonwa. Tetusunge avantu. Tetusunge chalo. I was watching a television interview in South Africa with one of my colleagues. They were asked, no, now that you are taking office, what are you going to do for your country? What is your vision? Caesar, not much. Not much. The interviewer couldn't believe it. He said, sir, did you hear my question? What are you going to do with for your people? Not much. And the chair was swinging left to right. Not much. Not much. Are you surprised we are where we are? It's an indictment on all of us Zambians. This golden bullet, we are in the remit of recommendations. The golden bullet for 2020, beyond that, is a leadership that can focus on this bullet of economic revival, economic restructuring. That's the one. To restructure the economy, to grow the economy, we have to do a couple of things. We have to do certain things.
The economy doesn't grow on trees. It grows on the right vision. It grows on the right policies. It grows on the management. It grows on prudence. It grows on cost reductions. It grows on knowledge. Not chipante pante. No. We need investment for the economy to grow. For the investment to grow, to come, we need an attractive environment. To have an attractive environment, I'm giving recommendations. We need, amongst other things, to be clear what sectors we're going to promote. Agriculture, of course, because it produces food for our people. We need to promote value addition. We've said these things before. To process what we produce, instead of selling maize, which we advise them not to do in 2018 into 2019, we should have been selling meal to Congo and stock feed to Botswana, not maize. Because we would have added value, we would have earned more, we would have maintained our jobs and created jobs. That's what needs to happen going forward. We will continue giving advice. We need to look at tourism. Don't tell me about Victoria Falls. I know. Waziba, there are things you can do around there to generate more tourists. You can bring tourists to see a drier Victoria Falls. You can attract them to come and earn more money. There is always value in good times and value in bad times, but you have to have an eye to see it. That eye is not there in the PF. You have to look at undoing what they did wrongly to KCM. That liquidator out of KCM. Return KCM to management. Management arrangement. You have to bring stability in the mining policies. Taxes. I didn't talk about it because I thought I would take too much of your time. 2019, we saw the reversal of taxes. They announced the introduction of goods and services tax. Sales tax, in simple language. Without planning, without thinking. They even announced it in parliament and gave an implementation schedule. And we told them, Mwagwira Pamwala, you cannot do that. You're going to destroy the economy. They made noise. Are you surprised Mwanagatwe is no longer finance minister? Are you surprised? Among other reasons. I don't want to touch other reasons, but on that one. What did Waryangandu do when he came in? He admitted without confessing publicly to us that you cannot implement sales tax and replace it with VAT without planning, without thinking. Forget about the technical arguments of VAT versus sales tax. You cannot do it because the platform is not there. There's a huge cost, money put on the VAT platform over many years. You can't just throw it in the toilet. This is a PF thinking. They had to swallow their pride and announce that they will suspend implementing sales tax. Even this year, they cannot. They have no capacity. Have they put it in the budget? Did they even explain to you in parliament? It's not there. But Chair, they say we don't advise them. We advise them. They didn't do what we told them. You don't have to like us. If you are in public office, you don't have to like people with different opinions. Just implement what they are telling you, especially when it's right, like we are right on many things. The test of the pudding is in the eating. We've been proven to be right. Don't digress attention. Don't say, no, when it doesn't rain, it's HH. No, it's not me. Cindy, eh? When you can't deal with Lower Zambezi mining issues, you say, no, HH sold Lower Zambezi National Bank. And you spend ZNBC time there. That's money. Save that money. That takes me to the point I want to make. Stability in the policies, mining, agriculture, tourism. Make our policies attractive. Once you've made them attractive, be consistent. Don't change every other day. That's a medicine here. Kulibe mungwala wina. Ndiye mungwala wamene uyo. Make your policies consistent. I doubt if Chagwanomics can bring attractive policies and make them consistent. I doubt. Maybe some of you believe that. But if you doubt it, look at 2019. The answer lies there for you. Disaster. Reduce the cost of doing business. 2020, we need to solve the electricity issue. Take out the load shedding. There's enough time in 2020. Don't argue with me, please. Bring the solar mix. Bring other energy mixes. And you can do it in 7 months. But you need money to do it. Imagine that I'm Munazi Jesus. That's a challenge. Let's take out load shedding. You can't run an economy, you can't grow an economy to even 3% without electricity. You can't. So we need electricity. And when you get advice, I have just been reminded here, Chanda Kasolo has been fired for telling Mr. Lungu that you cannot impose an illegal salary reduction on people who have not consented. That's a legal position. So do you know the impact of that? Others who are remaining will not give advice to Mr. Lungu. They will be afraid. By the way, don't take away the salaries of the people who you have not consulted. It's illegal, Chanda Kasolo has told you. Two, they don't have enough money. You are making enough money from Mukula. You are making enough money from traveling. Allowances. At this call, I don't want to forget, we have a recommendation. Pay all the retrenchees and the retirees camping at that ministry building. How do you finance that? We'll tell you. From 1st January, cut the presidential trips, allowances, cut it. Cut the ministerial trips only when it's essential. You will raise millions to pay those suffering citizens who wait for their money. Here's the money. If all you need is simple advice, take it. Unfortunately, unless you kill me, you can't fire me like you have done to Chanda Kasolo. I live on my own. I just wait for the people's answer. So you can't fire me. So I will continue talking. We will continue talking here. Can I repeat what I said? The media message is saying. All retrenchees in 2020, retirees who are government, quasi-government, who are in parastatals, who are what? Demand your payment. And the money is there. Where is the money? Let us demand that presidential trips, ministerial trips are cut. Use ambassadors outside Zambia. Why do you love traveling? Then the savings from those trips, you pay the retrenchees. More money for the youth, sell the jet. $130 million jet, we don't need it, we don't need it, sell it. Kulisa ndeke. Ngatsu. Very good. Ija ndeke ngatsu kulisa boy. By the next couple of months, we take office. Me, I've already found a buyer. A very good buyer. Yes. Do you think I'm joking when I travel around? I'm not joking. We are serious. We're not joking. We're not joking. I'm serious. This is not a joke. Stop buying councillors. Stop pushing by elections. That money you save, retirees, the youth who are unemployed and you completed school, demand for your job. When they tell you there's no job, tell them that the money is sitting in that plane. Because if you sell, when we sell that plane, the money, we put it in agriculture, you will see a difference. We put it in tourism, you will see a difference. Then the jobs will be created. Yes. Yes. I am serious. Zambians. Nde milomba. Lekeno ukwangala. Tuleyangala sana. As citizens. Tuleyangala sana. Tili kusobila. When you are not employed as a youth, as a child with school going, you are not in school, 2020 demand for your meal allowance. When they tell you, Kandulu or whoever tells you there's no money, tell them that no, HH told us there's money. When they say, where's the money? Say, the ministers who served in government after the dissolution of parliament 2016 must pay back the money. There is the money. 2020 is a year of action. That am I, Zoka. Before we even start thinking and using our grey matter here, ndala mataika kare patepa hapa, low hanging fruit, ndala mailiko. Imagine when we start applying our medulla oblongata, the grey matter. Where we fail here, there are a lot of you who have grey matter there. Leadership economy doesn't grow on trees, it grows on views, ideas, thinking, vision. When they tell you there's no money, tell them, no, stop corruption. The corruption, the Financial Intelligence Center. In 2020, we are challenging Mr. Chagwanomics that, can you recover the money that is identified in the Financial Intelligence Center 2018 report, over $450 million. Amama, Cindy, me muna remember report? Gadu, it's you. Please, sit with you. You wrote that report. Is it not Financial Intelligence Center? Financial Intelligence Center is not government. Government itself is telling the executive, $450 million. When you put 2017 review period and 2018, it's over $1.1 billion. Then Ibaku Uzani, I am told when they heard the announcement about this press conference, they started running propaganda ahead of this press conference. There is no propaganda you can run against us. It doesn't work. Ngasuziba, suziba.
Zambia!
Eche chwoye! Eche chwoye! Aje mberani to a support our president. Nikati eche eche! Kukamba ukamba, kome changwa, sambela. Echi echi.
Kukamba ukamba, kome changwa, sambela.
Echi echi.
Kukamba ukamba, kome changwa, sambela.
Thank you very much, Chairman. I am saying, Zambians, you must start demanding for what is yours. 2020. You need to be in school. When your sister, your mother, your niece goes to deliver in hospital, they ask you to take antiseptic there, surgical gloves. Tell them, no, you buy surgical gloves. That's why we pay tax to you. You buy. They'll tell you there's no money. Tell them, no, dala maziriko. Collect the money as indicated in the Financial Intelligence Center report. It is there. Don't fire the leader of the Financial Intelligence Center. If they argue, no, ndala mazakuta ushita kolekti, wiresani ndala mazamu kula. Are you aware what they want to do to the gold in Northwestern now? And to Chamba? Huh? They want to do to Chamba what they did to Mukula. Which one of you will benefit from that Chamba? They want to do to the gold in Northwestern, in Western, in Central, to what they've done to Mukula. Where do you see someone rushing to Mwinilunga? I was even watching him in the pit. Down there, he was in the pit. He says, so who is mining there? Everything they want to take. Resources that belong to the people of Mwinilunga, so that the economy in Mwinilunga can benefit, so that jobs in Mwinilunga can be created. What have they done? They've gone to ZCCM now. They've said, take over that license. Instead of saying, we will help you to mine properly, they are saying, we'll take over those mines. Greedy people. And Zambians are saying, Bena Valeria, you will read Jula. Will you learn Sala? Let us open our minds. I can go on and on. Licenses in 2020. We want to see a small business person who runs a restaurant to get a license within 2 days of applying at the council or wherever. Because the licenses are the ones that will allow the restaurant operator to keep the restaurant open, that will allow the restaurant operator to keep 2, 3, 4, 10 jobs there. If the license is delayed, it means the restaurant may close. Why are you delaying licenses? Title deeds. Give the title deeds to the Zambians. Give new mining license to Zambians. When they get the licenses, they will use them as capital to joint venture with foreigners. Then you have Zambians, you owning mines. Not someone going to Mwinilunga pit and looking around and says, whose license is this? And you're only thinking of yourself. You want to take the license from poor people. Instead of giving them funding, giving them technology, giving them Nimwebantu. Zambians, are you not looking? Are you not seeing what's going on? 2020 is the time for you to say no to lack of leadership costing you a lot. Why should you not be given land as a citizen? Land is being given to foreigners. Why? Because you have no bribe to pay. When they give to the Chinese, there is a bribe to pay. I am giving these measures for PF chairman who are saying we don't give advice to implement in 2020. But Zambians on the other side must demand for what is theirs. And I know they may not implement, don't blame us. We advise you. When you don't implement, we'll implement anyway, in a couple of months from now. We'll implement. Why are you scared to say we want a regime change? Yes, we want a regime change. So that we can resolve the 2019 difficulties. Regime change is a democratic process of taking out those who have failed through the ballot and bringing in competent and capable people. That's the regime change we're talking about. What crime have we committed? And to do that, we need an independent electoral commission. We don't need an electoral commission chairman who announces votes in Lundazi Central that are given to one candidate more than the total number of people who voted in Lundazi. When I say that, Kampiongo says, go and arrest HH. Kampiongo. Kampiongo. Katondo Street is still there for you. No one will remove you from Katondo Street. We will respect your rights, but you are failing to do your duty. When we say that, you should have supported me to say, HH, we agree with you. We will work to have a free and fair elections in 2021. Instead of threatening me. I'm told they had a meeting there, mobilization meeting, whatever. They were even dancing around. Remember, that hole you had, people were watching and saying, what a foolish bunch of people, dancing when we're hungry. You think people will help you mobilize when you are eating and they're hungry? They will not. Kampiongo, please, I rarely address people like him, because I don't like wasting my time. I have enough things to do. You cannot use the Home Affairs Ministry to threaten citizens exercising their constitutional rights. Yeah, Katondo Street will always be there for you. We'll support you there. Unlike you, we'll support you there. To be honest, that's where you belong. Ah, why should you be afraid? Me, I came from the village. I love to be in the village. Why does he feel ashamed to go where he came from? Katondo Street. We have a menu of things that we are recommending, but I'm saying to you, the people of Zambia, you have to engage. You have to engage. You have to get your national registration cards. Whether they are giving them secretly, go in that queue and get your NRC as well. If it means shout Pawoto, that's the only time I'm authorizing you to shout Pawoto. Then you can get your NRC. Get your voter's card. As long as you know watermelon. It's a beautiful fruit, eh? Watermelon. On the voting day, turn out to vote. I want to appeal to the people of Zambia. Can we unite? No one will solve this problem for you. You have to participate. This issue is no longer UPND versus PF. It is the bad which are represented by PF and the good represented by UPND. Yes. There are only two sides here. The bad, the corrupt, the greedy, the Mukula one, or the good, the UPND, the growth in the economy, the job creation, the business opportunities creation, the lowering of the cost of doing business. It is the electricity, so that you don't have load shedding on the good side. It is the price of fuel that must come down, which is on the good side. Choose what you want. So it's not PF or UPND. We should not fight. We should say we want the good. And the good happens to be with the UPND. I want to appeal to the PF members. PF members who supported the late SATA, who genuinely believed that Mr. SATA was going to help them, but God took him away. Remember when you and us were in opposition before 2011, which MMD cadres were beating you? It is Lusambo. When you formed government, where is Lusambo? He's a minister. Where are you who used to be beaten by Lusambo? You are suffering together with us. Njala is afflicting us. Because Njala sees Bamutunduka. So, let me return. I'm appealing to the PF members that suffered together with us in opposition. Remember, who was ridiculing Mr. Satan, calling him gay rights and all of that? It was Dora Siria. It was the Sunday Chanda. The same people who were harassing Mr. Sata are the ones enjoying under your sweat of PF. Think about it. Choose the right side, not the bad side. That's my appeal. There is no Mutundu here. We are all children of God. There's no Mutundu here. Kulije. What is there is a failure of leadership on PF side and the right leadership on the UPND side. Where do you want to belong? We are on the banks of the river. We are crossing the river. It's time for crossover. And we are crossing over. Come along. God is with us. Remember Moses taking the children of Israel from Egypt across the Red Sea. They arrive at the Red Sea. Pharaoh's army is pursuing them. They start insulting Moses. That's what is happening now. Oh, church, pichulech ta tole bomba. Tulech chula ifwe. Tole bomba. Tule bomba. But alone, the few of us cannot change things for you. It's all of you. The children of Israel turned to Moses and started ridiculing Moses, why you brought us here? Why have you pushed us through this desert? We are hungry here. Today you have to amanda. You should have left us in Egypt. Now look, Pharaoh's army is going to kill us. Can you see they are coming? We can't cross the Red Sea. Moses, you know he had a short temper. He went to God to pray. God, look at your people. They are now shouting at me. What should I do? If you read the Bible, God told Moses, Moses, go and tell the children of Israel to just move forward. Just move forward. Just move forward. I'll find a way for them. Tell the children of Israel to move forward. Let them continue walking into that sea. I'll find a way for them. When you are with Him, when you are with God, who can be against you? He went back there, did what God told him. Strike that water. The water opened up. The children of Israel went through. The last one was coming out of the Red Sea. Pharaoh's armies were moving in, and God crossed the sea. Then He opened it. Crossed the sea for the children of Israel to pass, then He opened the sea to take away the killers, the bad ones. This is no different from this country. You punish citizens, God will take you away. Yes. God takes away people in different ways. He removes them from the office so that new people can come in and run the country properly. That's what we're talking about. Don't be scared. I see generalists are scared. They think their relatives in PF will die. No, God won't kill them. He will just remove them from office and replace them with incompetent leadership. Don't worry. They will still be alive. And by the way, tell them we will look after them. We are not like them. We will bring back a professional civil service. No one will be retired in national interest. Don't be afraid. PF is telling you, no, UPND will harass you. UPND will harass you. UPND will take you to jail. Why should we take you to jail? We have something to arrest. We want to arrest the economy. Yes. Mambo mweo. Don't scare Munga. They are scaring Zambia. No, HH to arrest you. Let me tell you the truth. God is the one who took me to prison. As I said earlier, so I could see what we need to do there. And the torture I received myself, I have made a decision that no one have to go through what I went through. Not even those who did it to us. No one. Because if I did it, then I'm defying God. God took me there so that that thing comes to an end. If I do it to those who did it to us, then I'm no different from them. I do not occupy a higher ground. It means I'm in the pig hole with them. So do not be afraid of the UPND leadership. It is there to fix, to arrest the economy, to create jobs, to send our children to school, to bring farming back to where it should be. Then we can grow the economy. I debate with Dr. Msokotwane here. What levels are we looking for? We are all ambitious. We are saying, by the second term in office, we should be looking at moving towards 10% of the economy to grow. Because anything short of that, we can't create jobs. We can't buy medicines in hospitals. That is what we want to arrest. So do not be afraid. Do not listen to the PF scaremongers. They want you to vote for them so that they can continue eating and building at Forest 27. That's all. They want to use you. Come to our side. Yes, I'm dancing in white. I have said it all. Let's unite. Zambians, come together when it's necessary. We came together to deliver independence. We did not talk about tribe. There was no issue of Mumukayungwa Spalo. What tribe is he when we were fighting for independence? Atikimalos? Atilatimalos? No. Munakayungwa Spalo was needed. There will be no Mundia was needed. As was Kamanga. As was the old man Zulu. If they did it in Egypt, why don't we did it in Zambia? Praise God. Wonderful man. There was no one who asked Kapwepe, where were you born? What language do you speak? There was no one who asked Nkumbula, Where were you born? No one asked for so many of our freedom fighters. Mama Chikamone, Julia Chikamone. No one said, our member are the ones who undressed. She was undressing to send a message, and today we're independent. We loved her. Mama, we loved you. We still love you. That is what we should do now. Delivered independence. 1991. Most of you are too young. You didn't know what happened then. We came together to deliver multipartism. Took out one party state dictatorship. Now the dictatorship is back. Can we work together to deliver economic independence for all our people across the provinces of Zambia? All of them. That's my appeal to you. We can talk, we can work. Without you, we can't make it. 2020, let's go and work. You BND members, stop squabbling. You have no time to squabble. What are you squabbling about? Get on the ground, let's form branches. Invite the PF colleagues, those who used to beat you in the market. Today, they are waiting for you to reach out to them to say, listen, to the side of good, leave the bad. Go and reach out to them. NMC members, we must justify sitting in these positions. It's not just warming chairs. Let's help the people of Zambia. Let's help the people of Zambia. Journalists, you have a duty. Sell the message. Make the distinction, the bad and the good. Only two sides. PF has failed. There's only one solution, UPND. That's a message. Doesn't matter how you express it, that's a message. I have a lot of sleepless nights myself. How are we going to save our citizens from hunger 2019, 2020? 2021. In his leadership, it's not there. Chagwanomics will not help the hungry. Mr. Chagwa, please declare hunger as a disaster. You will attract local, regional, and international humanitarian aid. Do it. People are dying out there. Do it in 2020. Lesami pare. Mulimami tusishangwe, Karunga milame, Mulungu atalise, Zambi wechu wa muyula tukwa shimani, Leza mlele kenobana bakusikople.